Welcome to a sunny morning, day 7 of the 2017 Winter Universiad. We are officially 1 week into competition now here in Almaty, Kazakhstan. Let's start off at a men's curling match between Canada and Norway. Then we'll move to women's hockey, where Russia will take on China in the semifinal. Men's hockey saw action as well between Canada and Latvia. And out on the slopes, alpine skiing parallel nations event got kicked off as each country went head-to-head. We'll end at Alato Mountain with the biathlon mixed relay event, one of the most exciting races in this entire discipline. We will be kicking off this morning's highlights over at Almaty Arena with a men's curling match between Canada and Norway. Canada is 3-1 heading into this one. Norway, the defending gold champions from the 2015 Universiad, they are 4-4 heading into this one. Norway is led by Stefan Wallstad and Canada led by Aaron Squires. We will see Aaron Squires up first, throwing the last stone here of the first end. Here he goes. You can see here Canada has the only stone right now in that center target. Now they've got two, but Norway is up next in this first end. Here's Wallstad. He's going to throw it and try and knock out both or one of these stones and get closer if one is still in there. He knocks out both. A beautiful shot by Wallstad. You can see why they're the defending champions, and they're going to grab the first point in the game. Here he is again now moving on to the second end. He throws his last stone for this Norway team. It just barely gets into that 12-foot ring, but Canada is up once again. Here's Squires. Canada able to knock out two of Norway's stones. They get 2 points in that one. Now they're leading the way 2-1. The next couple ends would be very evenly matched. Canada gets 1 point in the third. The fourth end was a draw, and in the fifth, Norway had one as well. Fast forward now to the sixth. Here's Canada throwing their last stone of the sixth end. Knock out that Swedish stone. They've got three in there, so they pick up 3 points now. They lead the way 6-2 over Norway. But Norway would make a big comeback now in the seventh end. First, we will watch Squires throw his last rock for this Canadian team of the seventh, able to knock out one of Norway's stones as they start sweeping to get Canada's stone out as well. Wallstad here throws his last one. And again, we said they're going to make a comeback, and they do just that. They score 2 points now, just 6-4. Canada leads the way. In the eighth end, Norway would pick up one more point. Now on to the ninth. Here's Wallstad releasing his last stone for this Norway team. Some good sweeping by his teammates. We'll get the stone almost in the middle of that button there. They've got two in there. Canada's only got one, but they have one more shot at throwing, and it would be a successful one. Here's Squires. Some vigorous sweeping action by the Canadians. Knocks out both of Norway's stones. Canada picks up 2 points. They lead by three now, heading into the last end. Here's Norway. They're going to need a big comeback here in this last end. You can see Wallstad here, a very serious face as the stone makes its way up. It knocks out Canada as they've only got one in there now, and Canada has a turn. Plus, with only one stone in the button and down three, that makes Norway almost impossible to come back now and beat Canada. Here's Squires' last throw of the game. There we go. It knocks it out and stays in. Canada picks up one more point. They end the game 9-5 over the defending gold medalists. Canada very happy with this one. You can see here it was the sixth end that did it for Canada, where they scored 3 and took that lead over Norway. Playoffs will start tomorrow. It's ice hockey time now at Bolan-Sholokh Arena, where Russia took on Team China in the semifinal match. The winner of this game would head to the finals to battle for gold against Team Canada. Here's the coach for Russia, Alexei Chistiakov, and for China, Xiaobo Guan. Both China and Russia now got ready to kick off this playoff game. Russia would have a very dominant first period here, and that would be the deciding factor in this game. It would be the first period that closes it out for this Russian team. Maria Batilova gets it started for Team Russia here with a slap shot from deep. Watch it again. Just slings it into that top left-hand corner there. Now Russia leads 1-0, but they wouldn't be done yet. A nice pass here from Elena Dergacheva over to Elvatina Shitareva. Gets another one in here for Russia. Watch the replay. Keep your eye on number 59 here. A beautiful pass to 68 for Russia now to lead 2-0 over China. And after the assist, she wanted a goal of her own. Russia now on the power play. Dergacheva gets it in here. Off the rebound, shoots it in off the stick of a Chinese athlete here. She will get credited with this goal. Watch here, right off the stick of China's captain, number 7. That one good for, once again, another goal for the Russian team. They wouldn't let up in this first period. Lydia Malievko gets one of her own, slings it back top shelf here. Watch this one. Bam, right there. They keep it going here with a little give and go action. Sosina over to Shibanovo, back to Sosina for another goal. Watch the replay on this one. A great pass gets it wide open right at the top of the net. You'll remember Russia's Shitareva from the second goal of the game, but she wanted more. A slap shot from the top right down the left side of the goalie. That one will be her second of the game and bring Russia up to 6-0 over China. And to end the first period, Nina Pirogova puts another one in top left-hand corner. Now Russia at the end, 7-0 over China. The Chinese team came out on fire to start the first period, though. Here's Yingying Guan with the first goal for this Chinese team. Take another look at it, right past the left side of the goalie. And Russia would be at it again here. Tons of action from this team. A nice shot by Neon Tien is stopped, however, by this Russian team. They're going to take it back the other way with a shot of their own. Ludmila Belikova gets it to the Chinese goalie. Just misses the net here. Watch this again from Chinese athlete. Right around, stopped by the goalie, and Russia kicks it back out. They would be successful in their next attempt with a pass by Maria Batilova into Fanuza Kadarova. Watch this. Just puts it right past the goalie. Goalie had no chance on this one. Watch how quick this is. Boom, right to the back of the net. The next goal for China goes to Anna Shokina. Makes this one look easy. Finds the 5-hole right in front of the goalie. Just puts it in there, and it's another one for Russia. The last goal of the game is a Russian player as well. Fanuza Kadarova gets her second of the game now. Watch her. Dizzles around the defender. Top left-hand corner. That one is good for 10 now for Russia. At the end of the game, the Chinese just could not come back from the 9-point deficit. Russia would take this one 10-1 over this Chinese team in this semifinal match. They will move on now to play Canada in the final game in their quest for gold. At the end of this one, the shots on net are what did it. 50-15 between Russia and China. Let's head over now to Halyk Arena to catch up with the men's hockey. the quarterfinal game between Canada and Latvia would send one team to the semifinals and one out of the quest for gold. Heading into this one, Canada is undefeated with 3 wins, Latvia not far off with a 2-1 record. We saw Russia and Japan battle it out yesterday, and now the winner of today's game will face Russia in the next round. Canada and Latvia played in front of a sold-out crowd here at Halyk Arena, and officials from Sweden, the Czech Republic, USA, and Kazakhstan got some great action as the game went on. Take a look now at Canada's starting lineup. We see the teams here exchange some gifts, ceremonial tip-off there, and the starting lineup for Latvia. Their head coach is Gints Bikars, and for Canada, Brett Gibson. As the game got underway, Latvia would have an absolutely great game, but for this period, it would just be Canada who would put the puck in the net. You can watch some early action from both teams as it gets physical out there, but Gibson would remain calm. And you can see why a couple passes here, and a shot from Alexander Basso gets a wide open Pierre Olivier right in front of the net for the first goal for Canada. Take a look at this one. Morin chucks it right in there past the goalie. Great goal. Canada wasn't done in this first period. You can see Scott Simmons behind the net gets it out to Corey DeRoche, and he slings it in there. Take another look at this one. Here comes Simmons over to DeRoche, and it's in. At the end of the first period, Canada leads 2-0 over Latvia. But don't count Latvia out just yet. Oleg Sislenikovs, he gets wide open in the front, puts it in front of the net. That one is good for 1 for Latvia. Watch it again here. Maris Delveca gets right in front of the defenders, slings it back, and Sislenikovs gets it in. Now, they wouldn't be done here in this first period. Looking to tie it up, Olafs Oplex gets it up to his teammate. Slings it in right in front now, tied 2-2. Here it is, Sislanikovs on a hot streak by himself, steals that one and gets it up. That's going to be an assist for him plus his earlier goal. But Canada not happy with the tie game here. Here's Michael McNamee, misses the puck and then shoots it in. It's off the foot, actually, of Latvia's Yanis Bulatis. We'll watch this one again so you can see it a little closer. Right off the foot as he falls down, he slides it right in. Now Canada leads 3-2-2. The coach of Latvia, Gints Bikars, not happy with that one. And he wouldn't be happy with the third period either. Canada, the only team now to score in this last period. As Slater Duggett slides one in there for Canada on the power play. Now they lead the way 4-2. A good little rebound there from his foot. He's able to get it right past the goaltender. Canada happy with that one. And they should be happy. They'll continue to be happy here as Charles David Baudin slap shots and the rebound right into the stick of Michael McNamee. That one is the second goal for the assistant captain of Canada just in this game alone. He has had quite the tournament so far. No wonder that huge smile is plastered across his face. And here at the end, Latvia has one more shot at the end of the third to get one more goal, but that one will not fall. Canada takes this one 5-2-2 over the Latvian team. They will move on to play Russia in the quarterfinals. Latvia is out of the gold medal round now. Here's Canada, moves on from the semifinals. Very happy for this team. Shots on net here, Latvia 23, Canada 38. A couple other discrepancies as well. 14 penalty minutes for Canada, only 10 for Latvia. On the other end though, 25% power play efficiency for the Canadian team. They won 45-21 faceoffs. Now, Czech Republic and Slovakia will play later tonight. Let's head out onto the slopes now. Shumbolak Ski Resort will host the Alpine Skiing Parallel Nations team event today. Essentially, 2 men and 2 women for each country will race down a hill to collect points. At the end of each race, 1 point will be rewarded for a total of 4. And the country with the most points at the end, they will take the victory. Italy, and Russia made it to the small final. They will compete now for the bronze medal. Up first now for Italy, Michaela Speranzoni, and for Russia, Anastasia Silenteva. The Italian racing around the red markers for Russia, their athlete around the blue, as these two go head to head way down the hill around the markers. But at the end, it would be Silenteva who took this one with a score of 22.64, a whole 0.08 seconds before Speranzoni. Next up, the men took to the hill for Italy, Giulio Bosco, and for Russia, Alexander Andrienko. This one wouldn't be as close as that first female race, as you see the Russian pulling ahead. He will end with a time of 21.56, a whole 0.34 seconds before the Italian. Russia picks up their second point. The females are back up top now. Italy's Petra Smeldora and Russia's Yulia Pleshkova. Almost taking a tumble there, but she saves herself as they approach the finish line here. Russia will pick up their third point in this race with a score of 23.09. Last but not least, the final race, the men between Italy and Russia. They will take this point as well, and they're gonna go 4 points to Italy's 0 points at the end of this one. That means Russia will take home the bronze medal in this one. And for the big final, the Czech Republic will go against Austria in this one to start it off. Two women taking to the hill, Austria's Rebecca Fiegel and the Czech Republic's Martina Dubovská. Approaching the end here, you can see Dubovská has a bit of a lead there. She wins by just 0.11 seconds. Up next is Austria's Richard Legeb and the Czech Republic's Daniel Paulus as they head down the hill around the markers. This one would be close, and Austria would even out the score 1-1. Legeb would win with a score of 20.93. You can see here as they approach the end. After the tie, the women are up next for Austria, Denise Widner, and from the Czech Republic, Teresa Komochova. And this one would be the closest race of them all that you're gonna see here today. Just a margin of 0.02 seconds. Check out this one. Even as they approach the end, they look almost in sync. But like I said, just win. The Czech Republic lead now 2-1. Austria needs this one to tie it up. Czech Republic, if they win, the gold medal is theirs. For Austria now competing, Tobias Kogler, and for the Czech Republic, Adam Zika. It wouldn't be much of a race if we fast forward here. You can see Zika is going to win by 0.48 seconds, a huge lead in this one, and that gives the Czech Republic the gold medal in this event with a score of 3-1. They'll go home with the gold medal in this Parallel Nations team event. Austria, they'll leave with the silver, and Russia, they'll pick up the bronze medal. The The biathlon event at Alito Biathlon Stadium is similar to the ski event we just watched. It is a mixed relay where two men and two women from the same country compete in a relay competition. The women will ski 6 kilometers, the men 7.5 kilometers, and each have 2 bouts of shooting each. Athletes from Russia, Kazakhstan, the Ukraine, Slovakia, Poland, Finland, Canada, Australia, and Sweden got going. Here is the mass start for the very beginning of this race. Kazakhstan's Vishnevskaya comes out with a quick lead, and she would keep that dominance all the way through. Here she is approaching her first shooting bout, just 5 minutes into the race. She's getting her arm warmed up there. She will finish in this prone position first as she gets going on the race, sprinting to the next shot. Just under an 11 and a half minutes into this race now, she gets to the second shooting bout. It's the standing position now, and once again, she would come out on top, the first one to leave these targets. She would go 5 for 5 once again and then make her way to her finish line, where her teammate will end up heading off to the races now with a huge, huge head start. Kazakhstan's Yusanova gets going now. Look how much energy she has in this race. The Russian teammates exchange now, as well as the Ukrainians get going in their second leg of this race. They are now racing to meet the men at their starting spot. Here's Yusanova. She goes 5 for 5 from this shooting spot. That's her first, but the third in this competition. She's gonna get going now to her second. You can see here the Russian athlete and the Ukrainian athlete battling it out in that prone position. Russia goes 5 for 5. Ukraine goes 5 for 5. Yusanova still with a huge lead, just over 25 minutes into this race. Russia and the Ukraine coming right behind Yusanova as she gets her last shooting target there. 5 for 5 once again. Here's the exchange now as the men get going for this Kazakhstan team. Podkoritov, he is off to the races with, again, a massive head start. Russia coming in strong now. Suchliov, he's on the race, and right behind him is the Ukraine's Ivko. Coming up to the fifth shooting now, Podkoritov gets down into that prone position. He misses one of those targets, so he will have time added to the end of his race as he goes on to that last leg of the race for him. Podtorikov still in the lead now, with the Russian not far behind and the Ukrainian right behind him as he approaches his sixth shooting target in the standing position here. He goes 5 for 5. You can watch Russia there in the background going 5 for 5 as well, as Podkoritov makes it to the end of his race. Next up for Kazakhstan is their athlete Pantov for the final leg of this relay. You can see Russia make a quick exchange there as well. Ukraine would not be far behind. Here's Pantov with a big lead so far in this last leg of the race. Just over an hour into this race, the athletes approach the seventh shooting target. Russia and Kazakhstan head to head right now as Russia takes the lead. He goes 5 for 5. Kazakhstan just one shot behind now. He goes 5 for 5 as well. Now just a few steps behind the Russian. Kora Stilev now in the lead over Pantov. The first time Russia has had the lead, and the most important. Russia and Kazakhstan now come to their final shooting bout here, both of them standing up. Russia goes 5 for 5, takes the lead now. Kazakhstan, he also goes 5 for 5, but he's behind now in the part of the skiing race as both athletes head to the finish line. Korostilev for Russia crosses that finish line first. Team Russia ends with a time of 1 hour, 14 minutes, 37.8 seconds. Kazakhstan not too far behind. Here's Pantov. He will finish in second with a time of 1 hour, 15 minutes, 8.4 seconds. The Ukraine, they finish in third. They pick up the bronze medal in this event.